Namaste students, today we are going to discuss a topic from physics of class 9 and that is walk. Okay, so how will you define walk? You have already learned in your previous classes in class 8 that walk is said to be done when some force is applied and as a result a displacement is seen, isn't it? So how will you write the walk done expression? The walk done expression will be force applied and as a result you are going to see a displacement. Okay. Here one question arises. Can it happen like if I am doing a walk, like if I am applying a force on a table to shift the position of the table, but still I can't see any displacement? Can we consider it a walk done? In physics, we will not consider that as a walk done till a displacement is seen. Understood? So a walk is said to be done only when walk is said to be done. Walk is said to be done only when two conditions is fulfilled. Number one, force is applied. Force is applied and as a result a displacement is seen. In your textbook you must have read many other examples, like if a coolie lift a 50 kg luggage on his head and keep on standing at the same position for half an hour long. Will you say the walk is done by the coolie? No, because after lifting the luggage, he was just standing on the same position, and yes, he have applied some force to lift that luggage on his head, but the luggage was still at the same position, and no displacement is seen on the luggage. Okay, so there a walk is not said to be done, since displacement is missing there. Okay, you have to get these two conditions satisfied. Remember, force in Newton will be calculated accordingly, displacement in meter will be seen. Then a walk is said to be done in physics point of view. So here the expression comes like force into displacement. So let us see the unit of walk. Unit of walk done, how do we calculate? W is equal to, force will be calculated in Newton. Okay? Into. So distance will be calculated in, force will be calculated in Newton. And distance will be calculated in meter. So it will be what? Newton meter. And Newton meter have a special name as joule. Walk done. The unit of work done is joule. Is joule, and also denoted by capital J. I hope you understood this. Now, how will you define 1 joule of work done? When one newton of force is applied on object, okay, when force is equal to 1 newton, and as a result, the displacement is seen as 1 newton. Okay, when 1 newton of force is applied on object at position A, and as a result its position is displaced to B, and the displacement is seen as 1 meter. Then we can say that is 1 newton into 1 meter will be 1 newton meter, isn't it? That is said to be 1 joule. So I hope you have got the concept of 1 joule. Now the question arises, is the work done always in positive value? As how I have got plus 1 here, can I get minus 1, minus 5? Or any other negative value? The answer is yes. Work done is negative also. Work done can be negative also. See here, when a car. So here we can see the brake, which is also known as retarding force, is applied towards the opposite direction of the direction of displacement, isn't it? This is the direction of displacement. I am writing DISP. Okay. So you can see there is a total angle of 180 degree along this of two opposing direction of the direction displacement along with the retarding force. Here the force applied, or you can say the work done, is negative. Why? See here, work done will be seen as negative because here the F will be multiplied with minus of displacement. Why? Because it is in two opposite direction, you have to consider as minus S, and S is done, F into S will be the overall result, and here I will get the value of work done F in negative value. Yes, it will be negative value, F into S. Isn't it? So here we come to know work done is positive as well as negative. This concept starts from force applied and a displacement is seen. Here you also come to know the retarding force is also one kind of force, which is opposite to the direction of displacement, where the work done value becomes negative.